Well, good morning. It's a great day for aerospace in the state of Washington because the democratic process worked in the state of Washington that we have adopted a package of bills to clear the 777X for takeoff right here in the state of Washington. And I want to thank the people who made that democratic process possible, and that's the veterans of the United States of America. And could all the veterans here raise your hands today? Let's give a shout out to the veterans who made this possible. Larry Sequist over here, John Lovick, this is a great day because what happened in Olympia the last few days allows us to continue a great Washington State tradition, and that is to lead the world in aerospace. The BMW started in 1916. The 247, the world's first commercially successful jet airliner, the 707. I'll never forget sitting on it when I was 10 years of age and feeling the thrill of being involved in the aerospace future for the world. And that's what we're doing today. We will finish our first century leading the world in aerospace in a few years, and we're going to start the next century in a few moments when we sign these bills to allow the state of Washington's future to be as bright as its past in aerospace. And this airplane we're talking about today, the 777X, is a world beater. It will be 20% more fuel efficient than its predecessor because of the geniuses at the Boeing company, and we cannot wait to start that future. Now, this package, which we have adopted on a bipartisan basis, is unprecedented in the history of the state of Washington. It is unprecedented in scope. It is unprecedented in the protections it has provided for the machinists and the people of the state of Washington. First, it is unprecedented because it assures the completion, the assembly of the carbon fiber wing that is the heart of value of this jet. And I am pleased to say that the longest wing in Boeing history is going to be built right here in the state of Washington. Second, it is unprecedented because it assures machinists in the state of Washington that every derivative model of this next great jet is going to be built right here in the state of Washington. And third, it is unprecedented that we will assure that these jobs that are today enjoyed by the best aerospace workers in the world, Washington State machinists will make sure that they are not outsourced to any other state or any other country in the future. Because of the diligent work of Washington State legislators, and many of them were involved in this, they worked very hard in a very compressed period of time, and they built in protections into this bill to make sure that the 787 experience of another line being put somewhere else will not be replicated. So this is a great step forward of the state of Washington to assure that we have the longest wing, the longest commitment, and the deepest set of protections for machinists and taxpayers of the state of Washington in Washington State history. And I want to thank the legislators who worked on this project to make sure that we have confidence in 56,000 jobs and certainty for 56,000 jobs to bring home to our families in the state of Washington.